changing allegiance is a super hit formula to remain relevant in politics. This election, two parties have not remained untouched from this phenomena. Many change their party. Of them, Election Guerrilla picks for you the five most prominent faces to have shifted loyalty ahead of the battle for Delhi. Krishna Tirath, when an old guard shifts loyalty. Krishna Tirath is topmost on our list of people to change sides. She stunned all when she met BJP President Amit Shah, making the idea of changing sides clear and entering BJP. Apparently, Congress Campaign Committee Chief Ajay Makan then was caught unaware that she was joining the BJP. Tirath was one among a number of leaders who joined the BJP, including Kiran Bedi, Shazia Ilmi and Vinod Kumar Binni. She is contesting elections from the Patel Nagar constituency. A Dalit leader, Tirath had been with Congress since 1984 and served in Delhi and central governments. Tirath was a member of the Delhi Legislative Assembly between 1984 till 2004, and MP from Northwest Delhi constituency from 2004 till 2014. Vinod Kumar Binni, a turncoat who liked saffron more. Former MLA and Aam Aadmi Party rebel, Vinod Kumar Binni, just ahead of polls, joined the BJP. Joining the party, he said he was inspired by the good work done under the stewardship of Narendra Modi. BJP Delhi Chief Satish Upadhyay welcomed him, calling him one who was the first to blow the lid on the alleged undemocratic Aam Aadmi Party. Binni is pitted against Manish Sisodia in the Patparganj seat, from where Aam Aadmi Party leader Sisodia is fighting. Binni, former MLA from Lakshmi Nagar, had quit the Aam Aadmi Party earlier. During the Delhi elections held in 2013, he was elected as an MLA from Lakshmi Nagar constituency. He had defeated Ashok Kumar Walia of Indian National Congress by around 8,000 votes. He rebelled against Aam Aadmi Party for reportedly not getting a place in the cabinet. In January 2014, Binni accused the Aam Aadmi Party of betraying the people of Delhi and straying from principles. He was expelled from AAP last year on 26 January. Shazia Ilmi, when the lotus gets dearer. Shazia Ilmi joined the BJP in January ahead of polls, though she made it amply clear that she will not be contesting elections this season. Joining the Saffron Brigade, she said there is indeed a new political discourse in this country and we must all be a part of it. Shazia Ilmi had unsuccessfully contested the Delhi polls in 2013. She was also defeated in May last year when she ran as the Aam Aadmi Party candidate for parliament from Ghaziabad near Delhi. In a swipe at her, Kejriwal even retweeted a post from Ilmi in 2013 in which she had declared, "Hypocrisy, thy name is BJP." Shazia Ilmi had quit Aam Aadmi Party, alleging that the newbie party lacked inner party democracy. Now, with her entry into the BJP, the party finds itself in a good position to take on the challenge of the AAP, which it views as a major contender. Shoaib Iqbal, a known party hopper. Shoaib Iqbal is contesting from Matiya Mahal on a Congress ticket. Last year, this five-time MLA from JDU had joined the Congress, vowing to fight against the communal. He had then said he will prevent division of Muslim votes. Iqbal, who was an MLA from Matiya Mahal, had joined the party with son Muhammad Iqbal and nephew Khurram Iqbal. Congress termed his entry into the party as a move which will strengthen the grand old party. Last but not the least, Ranbir Shaukeen, reposing faith in the grand old party. Former independent legislator from Mundka Assembly constituency, Ranbir Shaukeen, and his municipal councillor wife Rita joined the Congress. He was elected an independent MLA in the 2013 polls from Mundka in Northwest Delhi. He attributed the move to his lack of faith in the BJP. He made it known that he believed in the secular credentials of the Congress. Interestingly, shocking similar expression of faith in the BJP and Prime Minister Narendra Modi has been consistent.
Powered by NNIS.